but to LE 32. Okay? If it doesn't say go to LE 32, you will not approve it, and you can't do this thing. The cardholder responsibility is to issue online check payments to vendors, assume full custody of the card. So this charge card, set of card, is going to have your name on it, whoever the cardholder is. Okay? You are going to be responsible for this card. Do not give this card to another board member to use, because if they misuse this card, it's going to come out of your own pocket. Not only is it going to come out of your own pocket, you will deduct whatever amount that was from the name council account, plus additional, we'll double that amount and remove that from your account, and then we'll probably for sure.
What happens if we buy a number of items you give out, and that's what it's called, to give out to the particular, particular activities?
Promotional items?
Yeah, but let's say we bought seven of whatever because of events taking place, and we need seven of that item, whatever they cost. So we only wound up giving 35. Now, what if we return the remainder number? I don't match anymore. What if we return the remainder of that back to the store?
No,
what do we do with that money?
Well, your promotion items that you give out is an outreach tool for the neighbor council. It's called a promotional item. It must have the neighbor council's logo on it, and it must be approved by the department. If your logo is not on that promotional item, you cannot give it out. Consider a gift of public funds. So, whatever you have left, you cannot return to the store. You use it for your next outreach.
What if it's something you can't keep? You have no storage or nothing, and you have to get rid of it because there's no more of them to give it to. The event is over.
Then the neighborhood council may want to consider to rent a storage facility to store your equipment and additional promotional items. Collect and save our orange invoices. So when you submit your monthly report, you have to have the original invoices and receipts. So we submit this report to the department and it must be mailed by U.S. mail or hand to the original department. You will not accept electronic copies, nor will we accept fax copies. It has to be the original. your storage of your phone. If you want your question, let's write it.
Well, the person who you're saying, ma'am.
Okay, so.
You don't have to get it at the end of your presentation.
Just write down your questions, so we'll do that. And then, the applicant is very confident in the answer. This is how we get this information. To your stakeholders, to get more involved with the neighbor council and the community. Okay. So have a booth at some type of events, have flyers, have your promotional items. This is how you get folks to be more involved. Neighborhood improvement projects, property payment, or planting trees or plants. Neighbor purpose grants. Neighbor councils are allowed to grant to 501c3 nonprofits or public schools. Okay. And 500 would be election related expenses. So, say for example, you have allocated 5,000 for your next election. Even though you allocate $5,000, then you approve it. When the time comes, you will need to re-approve again the specifics, the name of the vendor, the amount, and what it's worth. Neighbor councils must be provided a standardized format using the template provided by the department in the following category, as I mentioned earlier, 100, 200, or 500. Neighbor council is required to submit a border fee budget each fiscal year. Again, that's from July 1st through June 30th. The budget must be submitted to the department by the treasurer together with a second signer. They must sign the budget, and also submit the report also. Your board, as soon as you get all your contact information, the legal board, the name of the board member, your email address, a daytime phone number, your home address, your home phone number. This will be all confidential as to the purpose of the department's needs. However, you will also be able to provide a public email address as well as a public phone number. That will be given to the public. Request. Your personal information will not be given out to anyone, not even to your board, your peers, your board members, without your permission. Along with the budget, you will need to provide a strategic plan. Strategic plan is a short-term and a long-term goal, which is how you're going to spend your time. Okay. What are your plans? How you gonna better your community? What is going to be true? And that's something to think about. Also, we can provide an outreach survey, and that can be done online. Again, we need a current board roster. This is a sample of the budget. So, for example, Or you contact your inmate, as I said, and she can check with me, see what happens in the office. But if you don't get an answer, you can't wait, just leave your room, refuse yourself. Don't get caught, or else you remember your is funding request. Okay, allow more expenditure. All of the purchases of equipment, supplies, and services for the sole purpose of living the social capital of the council and then the community. Whoever you use your funds, you have to live in the community. You cannot use your funds to purchase a laptop or a school. You have to spend it on the gym. However, you may use your funds to purchase a laptop or a school to the neighbor council. But whatever equipment you have to use in the neighbor council, you cannot counsel with board members' home unless it's stored in your office or your store. You cannot get any more time. Social capital is a certain sense of the extent of neighbor council deals with social relations with the community. The RSA has productive benefits which for the mission to promote more citizen participation in governance and make government more responsible to the CNS. For example, this food requires $3,000 for uniforms. How would that benefit the community? So, this is what you would say to us. They don't really have a I There's no split charges. No donations of money or goods to individuals or groups. It's considered to be a public funds. No items or services from an entity that did not participate in the parent oversight process. The threshold amount of money over $5,000, three bids from local vendors, and they need a contact with him on terms of services. So say, for example, if you want to get community to sign with EmpowerLA to buy El Sereno, you need to get three bids from three contractors. Let us know which contractor you will have to go to. It's pretty much all of the contractors. Any purchase or capital improvement projects that increase the value of acquired property or do not go into the general fund, so they cannot use the funds to unify acquired property, have to be incorporated into the property.
That's a good question. What if there's only one bidder?
They have to have a contract with the city of LA.
So,
wouldn't
that be great?
If there's just one bidder, it's going to take a contract, it's going to take a long term period and it's going to be a contract. Event for projects that do not have the required insurance and permits. So if you're co-sponsoring or you're sponsoring an event, you need to get permits and liability insurance. Neighbor councils do have, we do provide liability insurance for the neighbor councils up to $5 million. However, there are times you may need additional insurance coverage. If that does happen, they will let you know, and the neighbor council will have to pay for that. What does your intake on your events, your permits that she will guide you on how to obtain the permit and the insurance and the issue of insurance? There's no third-party reimbursements. For example, Marlene says to her husband, oh, honey, can you go out and buy the refreshments and they'll reimburse you. So you write a check or you script her in his own name and send it to the work for reimbursement.
They have to be board approved council prior to that.
Again, all expenditure has to be approved by the entire board. Okay. Of course, you may not use your funds for alcohol, tobacco, firearms, or developing products or the casino. No purchase that violates the constitutional separation of church and state. City funds cannot be used to endorse religion or interfere with free religious activities. Perhaps make purchases that violate the city or state conflict of interest laws, supporting or opposing ballot measures or candidates, and difficult work and greater or less policy of attorney violence. You cannot sue the city because you're part of the city family. Cannot file grievances against another board member. So you're all on one team. There's no PayPal payments. You're not allowed to use funds to go through the PayPal services to pay for payments. When you're adopted,